Natalia Bonner, it's day 276. Today we're going to be stitching using my 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler. Now, since day one of this stitch along, the question that I have been asked more than any other question, if I could count the number of times I've been asked this question, you would be shocked. But the question I've been asked is there going to be a book as a companion to all of these, that has all of these designs? And I responded with, my lips are sealed to most of you, to your questions. So I think a lot of you maybe assumed something was coming, but we have been working, besides creating classes and all these other fun things, besides the stitch along, the tutorials, we have been working and creating a book, and it is going to be available for pre-order soon. I'm not giving you an exact date, but details are in the works and we're getting it together, so it's coming. I'm so excited. Okay, let's get stitching. I'll start out by using my blue Mark Begone marker and a rotary type ruler and marking a 9-patch through the center of my 6-inch quilt block. So two lines every 2 inches horizontal and also vertical. Now, this is a design, obviously here I'm marking it out and stitching it on a 9-patch, but it would be really cute actually quilted on an actual 9-patch. Now, at the points where my lines do meet the corners and they cross over each other, I'm going to be referring to those as intersections. I'll begin stitching on the left-hand side of the block at that first intersection. From there, I'll use the medium-sized curve on my 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler, stitch a curve up to that opposite intersection, then back down to where I started. When I get back to where I started, I'll stitch in my ditch down to the next intersection. From there, I'm going to repeat this process, stitching those curved point-to-point lines. However, this time, instead of one, I'm doing two. After I do the two, then I'll travel down to the bottom corner of the block, and I'm going to stitch three this time, working all the way across my block from the bottom corner up to the upper right corner. Then when I get all the way up to the upper right corner, I'll adjust my ruler and stitch back down to where I started. Now, if you're new to ruler work, make sure you always remember that you always want to hold your machine quilting ruler a quarter of an inch away from where you want your actual stitching to intersect. Those ruler feet on the machines are amazing, but you do have to always account for that extra quarter inch that they add. So I'll repeat that process one more time. This time now, well, actually two more times. This time going two of those blocks, and then we'll travel along the ditch across the bottom of the block where we'll stitch out one more of these melon shapes going up to the opposite corner, then back down to where I started. Once I've completed that stitching, I'll finish this design by stitching in the ditch around the outside of the block and then spritzing away those marked lines. I hope you enjoyed today's block and found a little bit of inspiration with my machine quilting. Now, just remember, you can pick up the panel, the rulers, the thread, all of the notions that I'm using in this video today over on my website, peaceandquilt.com. And don't forget to share your progress pictures over on Instagram using the hashtag #LetsStitchWithNatalia. That's where we will be selecting winners for weekly prizes. See you all tomorrow!